Coming right up, I've got some Google Maps tips and tricks just for you. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Tony and this is Tony Dawson Tech. So, Google Maps, we use it daily for satnavs or just finding our way. But how many of you dig down into the features that it has? I certainly don't. So coming up, I've got some tips and tricks to make you a Google Maps ninja. Before that, if this is your first time here, then thanks for coming along. Think about hitting that subscribe button. If you're a returning viewer, thank you very much. I really do appreciate that support. So Google Maps then, it's a fantastic tool, whether that's in your car as a sat nav, or if you're in a place where you've never visited before and you just need to get from A to B on foot. It's a fantastic tool and a guide to get you to places, as well as getting information on the places that you are visiting. But it does have some lesser known features that can be quite useful, especially if you don't know they're there. So for the next 5 or 10 minutes, we're just going to have a look at 5 tips and tricks of Google Maps. Maybe you'll learn something. Let's get started. The first one we're going to look at is probably a well-known one, but it's one I touched on a couple of weeks ago when I was going about sharing your location for safety. Now, I touched on a couple of messaging apps where you can do it direct within the apps. But if you've got Google Maps, you can share your location from Google Maps to within another location. It's a simple case of going into the menu, you'll see an option for share my location. You will then get an option to press the button where it says share my location. And from there, you will get the option of where to share it. Whether that's Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, via text message, you'll see the options on there. Click on there and it will share your location. Within there, you can choose either a duration to share your location or until you physically turn it off. One for the safety conscious, but also it's a simpler way of telling people exactly where you are if they're trying to find you. Next is a handy little option if you're somewhere where you haven't been before or you're unfamiliar with that place and you've just driven and parked up. You can instantly pin where you are parked and add other information so that it's easy to find your way back. Let's have a look at how you turn this on.
So open up your maps and wherever you are, you will see the blue dot. Tap on the blue dot and you will get these options. The one we're looking at today is save your parking. Now, when you click on save your parking, it will put a pin exactly where you've placed it. You parked here. At the bottom, you will see more info. When you click on more info, this is where you can put the extra information in there. So if you go down to parking notes, if you want to put notes on there for whatever reason, if you've paid for parking and there's a duration on that, then put your time left on there. It will give you a notification that your parking's running out. And if you really need it, you can even take a photo and add it to the note. Go away, do what you need to do. And then when you open up Google Maps again, that pin will still be there showing you where you've parked. Once you've reached your car, tap on the pin, you will get to this page again and just clear it and it will clear it from the map. Simple and easy. Really cool feature.
Now we've got something called the measuring distance tool. I see a use for this where if you're going out for a run and you want to plan a specific distance. You see in Google Maps, if you want to get from A to B, that's fine. It will show you the route, but it may be not the route you want to take. You can drag that route and it will find an alternative, but maybe you want to go up a road and come back down a road, or it's just some random route that you want to do either for a run or a walk, or you actually want to find the distance of somewhere that you have already walked and ran to see how you've done it. There's an option for this in Google Maps. I'll show you how to do it now.
This is quite easy on Google Maps. It's a little known feature. It's just for measuring distance. If you find your start point and just drop a pin, you will get the menu at the bottom. Scroll up and you will get some various options. One of them is measure distance. Click on measure distance and that's when it will start. And all you do is you move the screen around and you'll see at the bottom how it starts measuring distance. Now, if you're going from A to B, there you go, from that junction there, from that road there to that junction there, is 0.5 mile. What happens if I want to do, I don't know, go and visit somewhere else. So let's say I need to go and visit that little river there. Add a waypoint. And then I want to go to the corner of there. So we'll go there. Then maybe that one. and then maybe to the road where I'm going to meet somebody. 0.9 mile, you can get your distance. Use it for finding running routes, walking routes, or you just want to measure a distance. It's really good. Give it a go.
Google Maps is used a lot when planning visits, and this is a real good feature if you want to plan places to visit. Instead of writing them down separately, you'll have all the information there, and it's publicly shareable. If you've got a decent pub crawl that you've created and a list of pubs, you can share that or share it with friends. It's pretty simple to do. Here's how to do it.
Okay, so go into Maps then. This is obviously on the desktop. You can do this on the mobile, and then once you've created your list, it will appear both on the desktop and in mobile and vice versa. So let's say we're going for a pub crawl, I don't know, around Covent Garden in London. A London pub crawl. Go onto the menu, and then down there you will see something saying your places. Go to your places and then go to saved. In saved, you'll have three that are default and already there. If you click on the plus symbol, you can get to add your own list. There we are. It's a London pub crawl, so we'll click on create. That list has now been created. If you want to add a description, you can add one there. Now you can either click on add a place, or the easiest way to do it, if you don't know what you're adding yet, let's search for pubs. Once you've searched for pubs will come up. Let's say we get off the tube and we go to the Long Acre. Once you get on the left hand side, the place where you want to go, if you click on save, it will open up your list and add to London pub crawl. From there, we'll go to the Brewmaster again, just add it, and then you just do that all the way along to where you want to visit, and London pub crawl, and you'll add them like that. You then, when you go into your mobile app, you go into your save list, open your list once you're in London, and you'll see a list of the pubs or the places that you've saved. Try it. It's useful if you're going to a place that you've never been to before, and it'll save you time once you're there trying to find somewhere to go. So do the work first and make your list.
And finally, staying on the same theme of planning a trip. Now, we all know Google Maps is a decent, good sat nav. It will tell you when there's heavy traffic. You can see it on the map. When it gets red, it means there's heavy traffic. But what you can also do is you can plan ahead, so you can look at what date and what time you're going to be traveling and see what the expected traffic is going to be like. Now, this is obviously used what predominantly it was like, but it helps you show that if you're traveling at 8 o'clock in the morning in 2 days' time, what's it like? Is it better on a weekend? Is it more busy during a weekday? But you can plan ahead should you need to set off earlier or set off later. Here's how to do it.
So this is what I mean by planning a traffic route. Now, let's say I was going from Wolverhampton to Birmingham. Now, if you go to the side panel, click on the menu, you'll get the option there for traffic. If you click on traffic, at the bottom, it will give you live traffic and show you with a color code how bad the traffic is. Now, just looking at that, you can see there's heavy areas around here. That is live traffic. But if you're not traveling now, that means nothing to you. If you're traveling first thing on a Monday morning, you can swap this live traffic to typical traffic, change it to Monday and move it down to, let's say, 8 o'clock. And you can see where the busy areas are of where you're going. It really does help if you're planning a trip and you need to be there by a certain time, whether to, is it more beneficial to leave earlier or would you leave later? And you get the same sort of information up if you put in a start point to an end point and you're looking for directions. If it's not a live traffic, you will get, let's show you. So let's go from Wolverhampton to, let's say, IKEA. So there is, as it comes up now, if you leave now, it will tell you where you are. In the options, if you click on this and depart app, you can put a date in there. So let's say we're going on Monday and we're leaving first thing in the morning. it will tell you same sort of information down there, but it's typically 18 to 35 minutes. And you can start planning your trips with more precision, is one way to put it. Quite a useful feature.
That's it. There you go. There's some Google Maps tips and tricks. Any that you know that haven't featured yet, please let me know in the comments if you've got something to share with the viewers and some recommendations. There are quite a few features in Google Maps, so there will be more on this. Maybe we'll even delve into Google Earth. But if you did like that, please give me a like. It really does help the channel and it tells YouTube you enjoyed what you watched. If you want to support me in other ways, you can buy me a coffee at coffee.com. The link's down below. But for now, if you haven't subscribed yet, that's up here. And here's another couple of videos I think you might enjoy. Until next week, guys, I'll see you later.